So she had all three of the elemental monkeys. I didn't feel like commentating the battle. Ooh, a humble maid. Do I have a humble ingredient in my bag? Do you want the mushroom? Oh, absolutely. I got nothing. I got me some cash money. And before I forget again, give this to Polly. Also, I need to heal. Cause those damn preschoolers, man! Beat up Hibiki. Poor Hibiki. Darn herdiers. These are all trainers, I think, actually. Yeah. There is! Oh! Polly's evolving! Congratulations, your Polly evolved into Palpitoad. Oh, yes. Awesome. Palpitoad. It is now a water ground type, meaning Mudshot will now get same type attack bonus. Look at the stat increase. So good. All right, I'm actually going to switch you around for Mr. Zebra, because actually, I'm trying to think. No, Hibiki evolves, I believe, at level 29, and Mr. Zebra will evolve at 27. So we're gonna have Mr. Zebra lead the party. Mr. Zebra is also the only one not to have an item equipped, at least yet. Damn, its special defense is like terrible. Because of its naive nature, but it's fast. Totally okay with that, though. You're defensive and your speed got hit. Sassy nature, okay. I already looked at yours. You're neutral. Your speed got tanked, but your special defense is a tank. You got tanked, but tank. Yeah. Okay, so we're gonna lead with Mr. Zebra for a while now that Polly evolved, which means I have to change the sidebar. Yeah, you're a trainer. Fight me! Fight me, IRL! Ooh, learning Spark. Alright, so that's actually a physical-based electric attack that actually has more power than Shockwave. I don't really want to get rid of Flame Charge, at least not yet, because that helps with speed. And Quick Attack is still proving to be relatively useful, although having higher power and same type attack bonus does sound like a good idea. So we're gonna do it. I actually don't remember which one of Mr. Zebra's stats are higher, special attack or attack. I think it's special attack. I just looked at it too. An electric guitar. Okay, cool. Thanks, dude. Thanks. Which of Zebra's stats are higher? Oh, attack. Okay, yes. Keeping Spark was a great idea then. Shockwave is still going to be helpful for, like, at least for a little bit anyway. It'll be helpful if I, like, run into some evasion crap. Okay, so let's see here. Go to the bag. I want to heal Zebra up instead of just running all the way back to the Pokemon Center because that'll just take forever. I think this is our last trainer. Unless that couple down there is our trainers. Actually, I think there's a couple trainers left now that I think about it. Crap.
Dancer!
I like how he's black. Hibiki wants to swagger. Do I have anything that I don't really want? Sand attack, I guess. I don't really use sand attack. So I guess we'll teach Hibiki swagger. I mean, she's got a swaggle tooth, so... Swaggle tooth, I don't even know anymore. Don't listen to me. I pressed the wrong button again. So, let me see here. Keeping the team balance is a difficult process. You're not trainers, okay, that's fine. Are you a trainer? Oh, you're a painter, dude. Artist Horton has a Sigilyph. You know, I'm gonna leave this battle in, because this shouldn't take. I should be able to make quick work of a Sigilyph. Sigilyph. That makes sense. That's right! Okay, so we're faster than it. And I'm gonna hit it really hard, because it is part flying. Even if Mr. Zebra can't take it out before getting KO'd, I'm just gonna switch over to Hibiki and Assurance it, because it's psychic. It's flying and psychic, which is a weird combination. Not really, actually, no, because Natu and Zatu are flying psychic, because they're birds, but that makes sense. This thing, I don't even... What is it? What does the Pokedex say it is? I don't even know. The other thing I need to look up... Speaking of looking things up, I need to look up where I get the experience share, because I forgot. I forget where I get that. I have this. I'm going to use it. And then, while I'm at it, we're going to use the Super Potion. I'm actually starting to run low on items again. Which is funny, because before I started recording this episode, I actually stocked up on items, too. Hey there, how's it going? This way. Okay. Now, to contact him. It's me. Elisa. Please lower the drawbridge. I have a couple of trainers here who want to challenge you. Okay, thanks. Now watch this. Who put a cutscene in my Pokemon game? I have a TV gig, so I've got to go. The gym leader of the next town may take some getting used to. Do your best, both of you. What I am is a trainer. I prove I'm right by getting stronger and winning in battle, even against the champion. What is with him? This is true. A bridge would be meaningless if no one ever crossed it. Bridges connect the world. It's a solid. That's a solid as a symbol. Blah, blah, blah. I can't speak English, apparently. I just noticed there's another guy up there, and I want to fight him. I want to bite him at PAX. Oh, there's another one over there, and there's a hidden item over there. I'm gonna go pick it up. I can imagine what's inside. I really hope there's not, like, a dead body. Lois? With your Muna, that I'm going to just keep going, because I'm already talking in the middle of this fight, and I don't feel like cutting to when I totally kick your butt. Hibiki's just leveled up. Okay, never mind. Mido just leveled up too, so it doesn't really matter who I switch to. I'm going to switch to Mido, because Mido's the lowest level. So getting experience at Mido will be a better solution. Zen Headbutt! Oh, crap. These high-power moves that are... Stab!
Same-type attack bonus, man. Same-type attack bonus.
See, if I could've got Stab on that, I guarantee I could've killed it. I don't think Muna's very defensive. Might be special defensive. I don't know. I
couldn't tell you.
Great ball. That sounds great. Ah, Pokemon! I didn't put a repel up. Oops.
It's a Minchino.
Minchino's a neat Pokemon. I haven't used one, though. I don't know, I might... I know Trev was breeding for shiny ones and did end up getting a shiny one. I'm going to put a repel up before I forget to again and then yell at myself for being stupid. Repel. Away! Oh. Audino! Have I explained Audinos yet? I don't remember if I have, because it's been so long since I actually, like, was consistent with this series. I'm just going to fight it with Mr. Zebra. I'm actually going to fight a wild Pokemon, yes, because Audinos give a ridiculous amount of experience. That was a crit? Wow. Had a Norm Berry on it. But Audinos, they give this, like, ridiculous amount of experience, and I was actually looking for Audinos to fight while I was trying to level grind. I ended up not being able to find any, so I just decided, let's fight trainers that I'm going to fight off-screen anyway. Save everybody a little bit of time, right? It's paralyzed. Good job. It's times like this that I wish I had Quick Attack still. But I used all the other moves. Look at that. 1230 experience from a wild Pokemon. Like, what? Why? Why is it a thing? There's tall grass here. And taller grass. Dark tall grass. What do you got, dude? Backpacker dude? How going? Michael! As a Palpitoad. Ooh. No need to worry. We know what Palpitoads are all about. We are gonna... Oh, you are low on health, Mido. Let's see if we can get Mido out and he can tank a switch, maybe. A switch in, you know. He can tank the switch in. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Perfectly fine. Perfectly A-okay. Just gonna, you know, get the super potion, and then we're gonna just seed bomb this Palpitoad and it'll be done. Look at an uproar. It caused an uproar. Oh. One shot done. One shot done. Got some reasonable experience from that. That wasn't bad. I just wanted the item, actually, to be honest. Ooh, a revive. Glad I came for that. There's an item over here. Zinc. Okay. Stat boosting. Why not? So let's run across the bridge, it looks like. There's a thing. I want the thing. No, no! I didn't want to do that. Okay. Hi there. Right. I already knew that, and that's kind of why I was... Genius Wing! So you can pick stuff up on the bridges. Where is it? I hear it. I'm gonna be a weirdo and have to pick up everything on the bridge. Hi there. I see. We got a Pokemon! It's a Ducklet. Ducklet's actually a Pokemon I kind of considered for the team. But then I decided to split our water and flying type apart. For reasons like this, where you would have a quad weakness to electric. So... Yeah, in case anybody was wondering, I did want to use, what is it called? It's like Swan something, I forget what it's called, but... I was considering Ducklet for the team, and just went against it. Bridges are amazing because they are a symbol of connecting the world. But the guy on Route 5 is saying the same thing, isn't he? Oh, that's neat. Charizard! Welcome to Driftvale City. Oh, thank you, sign. I feel welcomed already. Oh, hi there.
Humph! So you're the trainers Eliza was talking about, huh? I'm Clay. I'm the gym leader around these parts. Don't be expecting no welcome now. Because when we lowered that bridge, the Team Plasma guys we caught done escaped in all the ruckus.
What a bother. We're grateful that you lowered the bridge, but how is it our fault that they escaped?
You can say whatever you want. But what's important is y'all showed up, then Team Plasma escaped. Maybe it's a little heavy-handed, but you ought to start looking for Team Plasma, too. You're both talented trainers, aren't you? Tell you what. If you find Team Plasma, I'll let you challenge my gym. Life's all about give and take.
Well, I suppose that's fair. But really, we would have looked for Team Plasma even if he hadn't asked. I can get stronger while beating that bothersome bunch. Ryan, I'll go on ahead.